Like this damsel in distress.
Live every weekend or every other day. So we're having a bit of fun here today. Thank you very much for joining us.
Now, this is a very impressive vehicle. How are you?
Yes.
Tell us your name and a little bit about your vehicle.
Bob Adam. It's here.
Thank you.
feel like I'm a shining
light in the season of the year. Oh. Yo! Commanded the highest price, and they were very sought after by the Parisian Hanley, believe it or not, McHannon. And they got the biggest price, three times the price of any other skin in the world, believe it or not. And that's from these very, very shores. It's a small fact that you might not know. So when they caught up all the rabbits and long nets, it was done by professional long netters. And these guys, and one of my uncles, a great uncle of mine, was a professional long netter. And they used to catch hundreds and hundreds of rabbits every home. Now this is something you can teach the dog. By any means, you have to pick it up from the dog's body. And the fudge isn't the most fantastic marker. My other dog is somewhat better. But one fudge does it work in a net very, very well. The dog has to understand the net, why the net's there. See up there, you lost the dummy. You dare. Round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Keep it going. Here we go, fudge. The dog very well jumping through the net. The dog has to understand the why the net's there. Up we go. It looks an easy thing to do, but when you see a dog that's not tuned in with a net, that hasn't been trained, hasn't been worked with a net, it becomes very, very different. Now one thing I should do is probably take an untrained dog into the ring so you see the difference. There we go. Now what you want the dog to do is pay no attention to rabbits that hit the net. If they run and they miss the net, that's all very well. You want the dog to go and get them. But if the rabbit hits the net, you want the dog to leave it alone. Now, this is the most difficult part because a lot of dogs won't leave the net alone. But it runs in. This way. There, jump behind, leave it alone. It doesn't want to chase, it doesn't want to pull at it, and that's what you want. A lot of dogs, when you do that, go to the internet after the dummy. Yup. And they'll try and pull it out, try and retrieve it. That's not what you want. The dog must understand what the rabbit's caught at that stage.